Well, it's been 2 years since we last heard from her, but the singing sensation Gabrielle is back with what promises to be another soul-searching hit. And she joins us now. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's lovely to see you so early.
Likewise.
It's not too early for you, though.
Not at all.
You're just saying you've kind of become a mum again, haven't you?
I have. Because I have two nieces who live with my mum and I, and the youngest is one now. And we've had her since she was 5½ weeks, so that was an amazing experience. So I'm kind of used to to bed really late. She hasn't got into that routine yet.
Really?
It's like, in order to get her to sleep, you have to literally stay up until midnight. If you have her bathed and ready, for like 8 o'clock, honey, she's up at 9 o'clock. And that's it, and eyes are wide open until about midnight.
And there's no sleep.
Yeah.
So you have to sort of try and coax her to sleep slowly but surely.
Doesn't work.
So it was a rest to come in here this morning.
Totally.
Well, that's nice now, because of course Jordan is what, he must be nine?
He's going to be nine in a few days' time, yeah.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Is it quite good fun having had Jordan, who's getting to that age now, he's becoming a lot more independent?
Yes.
To have to go back and look after the babies again?
It certainly is. I mean, Jordan plus an extra two, and it works, two girls, but he's loving it. It's lovely.
I bet. So we were saying you've not been around for a couple of years.
Yeah.
Obviously, you've got a new family, but what else have you been doing?
What have I been doing? Trying to write this album. Although I haven't been doing that all the time, because obviously having a new baby and stuff like that, it means that, I was just spending some serious quality time with the new baby bonding.
Sure.
Just family hang time, and then trying to go in the studio every now and then to kind of right, so it's been successful. We finished the album.
Excellent. And the new single, Say the Same, is out on May the 3rd?
May the 3rd.
Excellent. Let's have a quick look at the video. Gabrielle was just saying that's the first time you've seen it.
That's right. I've seen like little snippets of it, but it's actually seeing it and being into some of the secrets of how it's filmed.
I know, because I mean that's Piccadilly Circus.
That's right.
That's Eros, but you weren't actually there.
I wasn't actually there. I don't think the director would like me saying that. Mike, I'm sorry, Mike Lipscomb, but
But he's done a great job, because you would never guess it. Where were you? You were at home with your TV and your feet up, having a cup of tea.
No, I didn't get to see those wonderful sights. I was stuck in a studio for hours, and I just felt sorry for the extras, because I think I left the set at like 4 o'clock in the morning. And some of them still hadn't done their scenes yet, and I was like, oh my God.
It's a long old shoot doing these video shoots, isn't it?
It's a long old shoot.
I mean, you've had so much success, and it's been 12 years?
11 years.
11 years since Dreams came out. Which is
June.
That was just before I left school, and it was such an important sort of song for you.
It certainly was.
And at the time, but even all this way down the line, and you're still doing these video shoots and these songs, are you still enjoying it?
I'm enjoying it. I've got to say that, because filming videos is such a long winding thing, I respect any actor. It's not something I'd ever want to do, because it's too long for me. But my best bit is actually just going on stage and performing.
Yeah.
But it's great to kind of look back on the videos and say, oh wow, this is what I look like. Or, just, it's something, it's a collection for the children and grandchildren, I say. So it's kind of fun. I do enjoy it.
And a great collection at that. I mean, sort of relatively, with Dreams becoming such a hit, could you ever have imagined sort of this far down the line what things would be like? And do you ever get tired of the song as well? Because people always still hark back to it, because it was such an amazing sort of tune.
Right. I mean, I could never have imagined what's happened, throughout my career, all the good things. And, when people say to me, do you ever get sick of Dreams? Never. I never get sick of Dreams, because it's where I began, and it's a song that I'll always be remembered for. I mean, I don't wear the eye patch anymore, but people still ask me about it.
Really?
And I've got to be honest, I'm not mad. It's fun. I had a great time with the eye patch. Yeah.
It was cracking. It was a great look and a great song. Thank you very much for coming to talk to us.
Thank you.
I know you're going to be performing for us later
That's
on as
right.
well, aren't we? So we'll look forward to seeing that. But for the time being, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, can you believe this? It's been 2 years since we last heard soul sensation Gabrielle. It's gone so quickly. We're going to be finding out what she's been doing in about 25 minutes' time in that, but I guess she's been getting together this song. She's performing her new single, released on May the 3rd, called Stay the Same. Mm-hmm.
find now that love is not the same. I have watched you try to cover your mistakes. I don't care about what the people say, but it's down to me. I know my mind, and I will find my way. And I don't regret the time I spent my time with you. It was not in vain. And please you. The time had come for change. It's when I realized that I really did need you. And I knew right there I couldn't take the blame. And I don't regret the time I spent my time with you. It was not in vain. With the time I spent my time with you, it was not in vain. I don't wonder why, where it all went wrong, and how you lost your home. You're the reason that I've gone home. And I wonder how you came to change, why you lost your way. Well, I still stay the same.
Gorgeous.
It's going to be a hit, isn't it?
I think it's going to be a big hit. A lovely smoky voice. Thank you very much, Gabrielle. It's lovely to see you. There you go, the new single out on 3rd of May.
And she's coming in for a chat as well.
Yeah, we're going to be chatting to her a little bit more. You a big fan of Gabrielle?
Love a bit of Gabrielle, me. Rise again in all of that.
She's looking quite scared. Yeah, don't worry, we're keeping this end of the studio.
Yeah, don't worry.
She knew he was going to be here, that's why she had her sunglasses on.
We've got Gabrielle with us this morning. She's already performed her new single for us, and she's here to have a bit of a chat as well. Good to see you this morning.
Thank you.
Now, I don't know whether you've been doing like Phil Tufnell and lying on a beach, but we haven't seen much of you, have you, for the last couple of years? What have you been up to?
I've been chilling at home with the children. I've got three now, my son and two nieces.
Right.
And I've just been, you know, having some quality hang time. And in between that, trying to write this album, which hasn't been easy, but we've been successful because it's finished now, which I'm excited.
Is that quite a difficult process, actually? Is that the bit you like, the sitting down and the writing the music, or do you like the sort of out and about promoting it or the performing? What's your bag?
I love the writing, just sitting down with my producers who actually produce great music that inspires me to write what I do. But the best bit is for me is actually being on stage and performing. Mm. It's probably one of the hardest bits because you're away from home. But when you're on that stage, you've got loads of fans out there singing your songs. It's fantastic. It's a buzz that, you know, you just can't compare it to anything else.
Fantastic. Well, you were on our little stage in the corner of the studio this morning performing a bit earlier. Should we have a little look at your new song?
Cool.
Stay the same. going to be a hit. We're already swaying to that one. What's it all about?
Basically, it's about change. I mean, relationships go through change, and it's a case of two people growing apart. But, you know, whereas usually you're in a relationship and you want to grow together, you both want the same things, and that's being in love is all about. And when one of you's changed and it's not for the better, it's a case of, you know what, I'm out of here, this is not what I want. And it's a case of just questioning why one of you changes so much.
And the dramatic things you go through.
That's right.
I think that'll touch a chord with lots of people listening.
Yes.
Do you know, you made me feel so old this morning when I came in and looked at our question. 11 years ago for Dreams, where's that time gone?
It's flown by. It's totally flown by. I like to feel that it doesn't seem as long as it has been, but it's nice, you know.
Was that a life-changing moment for you, that hit?
It certainly was, simply because of the fact that when it first came out, you know, it was one of many new songs that was released. And I never actually sat back and thought, you know what, this could be it. I just wanted always to sing. And it's one of those things that just being able to have the platform was good enough for me. And what followed was just amazing. But, you know, there's been some, you know, rough times and good times, but mostly good. So I'm not going to complain at all.
But you then took the time out to have your little boy, who's what, nine?
He's going to be nine in a few days.
That time's gone as quickly as well. I mean, did it seem like a risk to do that? I suppose you didn't really have any choice, but
not
risk in terms
all.
Of your profession, because a lot of people might think, gosh, just had a hit, just on the road, and then
It came at the end of the album. I was in love. You know, Dreams had been a hit. The album had been a success. And it felt like the most natural thing to do at the time, you know, and, you know, I was very happy. So, and he's like, you know, my baby, he's still my baby, even though he's going to be nine.
God, is it difficult to juggle? And any working mum has got all sorts of different juggling to do. Is it easier, do you think, in your job or harder?
I don't think it's easy, but I think that it's been made easy by the fact that I have an amazing mother who's an amazing grandmother, and she takes over that, you know, the job of, you know, the responsibility when I'm away, and I leave her in total, how would I say, it's one of those things where I go away and I have no qualms whatsoever. I'm happy, the kids are happy, they're safe.
Yeah, and you can just feel that that's something that somebody so close to you is
that's
looking after them.
Yeah.
Has he got any signs wanting to sing? Sing in the bar?
Well, he's singing a lot of busted songs at the moment.
Is he?
Yeah.
Rocking.
Basically, we were given a few tickets to go by the head of the Violin Records, Nick Gatfield, so I want to say thank you to Nick, and took my son and niece, they're both eight, and they loved it. I enjoyed it. There was McFly, there was Busted. I was kind of jealous because I wanted to be up on the stage.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, it's not me.
Has he seen you perform a bit?
He has, but he usually, after a few songs, he's like, I want to go and play now.
He must have a much better idea and understanding of what mummy does, because I imagine as growing up, you just kept going away or whatever.
Yeah.
Is it sort of watching him change and understand your career must be quite interesting as well.
It is, because I tell you what, he's quite funny at school. Kids arts him, you know. Is it true? They said, you know, is your mum really Gabrielle? And I was like, no, you've got the wrong person.
And he's like, she's just mummy.
Yeah, and now he says that because he's like, mummy, they asked me, and I just, no, you've got the wrong kid. And it's really cool because I think he's watched me kind of deny sometimes, you know, you Gabrielle, I wish I was, that's my line. Just so you get on and do your
thing.
And he's fabulous like that. He's so unaffected by it all, which is just amazing to watch him from being this little niffer who kind of didn't know and just thought everybody's mum was on the TV to kind of getting that level of understanding. But he's great.
So it's becoming old. Would you advise him, do you think, to go into the business? Is it something you want for your child, do you think?
I wanted to be a lawyer.
Yeah, I know, because that's what you wanted to be. That's why I'm asking, because you made a big change in what you wanted.
Well, and, you know, like my mum before me, it's a case of, you know, get your qualifications. Nobody can take that away from you. I didn't really follow that through because I had my dream. But I did say to my mum that if I had till a certain time to make it, and if I didn't, I had the rest of my life to get qualifications. But with him, I'm saying, get your qualifications
it's a different rule
when you're mummy.
Listen, best of luck.
Thank
you.
You've
made such success. He's got a good example to follow, hasn't he? Best of luck with the new single.
Thank you.
So if you're on school holiday, no getting out of it. You still got to get those qualifications, I'm afraid, Gabrielle says.
That's official. That's it from us for today. We've got a great show for you tomorrow, though. Jack Ellis from Bad Girls is going to be here, and Patsy Palmer. You can ask if she's going back into EastEnders.
She can. Have yourself a lovely day.
Have a lovely day. We'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.